Hi, it's Maggie Boy.
Did you know that you don't need a visa and you don't have to be vaccinated to enter Korea? You just need to follow 3 steps.
Step 1, KETA. Step 2, Q-code. For quarantine exemption, you need to register your pre-departure COVID test result. Step 3, safe to go for PCR test upon arrival. This video is updated on 9 June 2022. The regulation keeps changing. If there's any updates, I will try to update it in the comment section below. But the best is to check out the Korean Embassy website before you leave. I'm gonna show you how to apply for this KETA pass. You click on that, select your continent, which is Asia Pacific. So when you apply, make sure you read through everything because there's a list of documents that you need. After you've read through everything about the disclaimers and stuff, and click next. So on next page, you enter your passport number and then your email address. So the email address is important because they're gonna send you the results of your application to the email. And the first thing you see is it tells you to upload your photo page. Make sure you scan it and upload it. And one thing to take note is that there is a size limit. So the size limit is 300 KB. Next is select your nationality, Malaysia, male or female, surname, date of birth, expiration. So make sure you renew your passport and get some extra years. My phone number. Have you ever visited Korea before? Yes. Select your purpose of entry. The next thing is the postal code of where you're going to be staying. By using the address of your hotel, you can actually look up the postal code using the address finder. Then it tells you to enter your contact number in Korea. So this could be your hotel number, a family friend, or whoever that you're staying at. Select the category that best represents your current job. So the next thing you need is to upload your photo. Resize it according to the specifications. It's less than 700 by 700 pixels and less than 100 kilobytes. Usually photos get rejected when you don't follow the proper specifications.
So next thing is personal information. Enter place of birth, return your passport. So for me, it's Kuala Lumpur. That's where I was born. Enter plan duration of your Korea trip. Do you have any acquaintances? Yes, I do. I have friends in Korea. Enter name. I will put my wife's name. Do you have an accompanying person? No, I'm flying alone. Have you ever visited another country? Yes, more than 5 times. Are you currently employed? Yes, please enter information below. Monthly income? I'm not gonna tell you. Press next, confirm. Let's check all the details, but it's correct. Nationality, Malaysia, birthday correct, sex, male, passport number. Make payment. So make sure you check all of the information because there's no refunds if you get it wrong. Alright, application has been completed. It's quite easy to apply, very straightforward.
And after 3 days of submitting my application, I got my confirmation email. So the next thing we need to apply for is actually Q-code. So Q-code is Korea's quarantine pre-entry system where you can apply for quarantine exemption. So there's a bunch of documents that you need. Firstly, a valid passport, your valid airline ticket, and valid negative COVID-19 test results.
To enter Korea, you need a rapid antigen test taken at a hospital or clinic within 1 day of departure, or pre-departure PCR test taken within 2 days of departure.
So let's go check out how we can apply. Press the go button, select your continent and nationality, read all the terms and conditions and agree to it. Then you gotta input your passport number and your email address. As usual, you just have to fill in your information according to your passport. Input your family name and full name in English, your birthday, your passport number. So next, they're gonna ask you to input a lot of your entry and travel information. So make sure you get your flight ticket and check all of these details correctly. After you got your flight details keyed in, next is the address of where you'll be staying, your phone number as well, and available contact phone number. Input your negative COVID test result, check test method, date, result, and date that it was issued. Input your flight number and seat number. And of course, you need to input your health condition. Make sure you read carefully, and they are asking you if you have visited any countries in the past 21 days, or if you have the following symptoms. Press next and submit.
You'll then get an email confirmation where you can print it out and bring it with you to the airport.
So before you leave KL, you need a PCR test, but you also need another PCR test after you arrive in Korea within 3 days at the airport or at the clinic, both at your own cost. Safe to go is for those who want to take a PCR test at the airport. So after you go to safetogo.com, you can sign up, then it will tell you to enter your travel information. Add in your arrival time and add in the info of the place you'll be staying. So now you can book your COVID test. So click on book your reservation. agree to all the terms. So in the website, there's a list of prices that you can take a look at. The next thing you want to find out is where is your terminal and where is the test going to be. So that depends on what airline you're going to be flying. So it looks like MAS is on Terminal 1. So I'm going to click Terminal 1 and you will see how much time it takes for you to get your results. So in this case, I arrive around 7 a.m. So maybe I want to take something that's about 8 a.m. hopefully, and input a contactable number. Click complete. So now I have my arrival PCR test ready to be taken. So let me recap. You need to apply for KETA, Q code for quarantine exemption, and for you to enter your COVID test results before you fly. Safe to go for a quick PCR test when you arrive in Korea. If you have any questions, make sure you leave a comment down below and I will try my best to answer. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in Korea.
This is mine. What? No.
Oh fuck.
Good, right?